Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Rabbi srahli sadri wa yassirli amri wa hlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Respected elders and beloved brothers and sisters in Indonesian Muslim community in Calgary, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Prophet Muhammad SAW is reported to have said in Kitab Jam al-Kabir, that is the book of ahadith, the collection of ahadith of Imam Tabarani. So he, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is reported to have said that he was so amazed. He was so amazed by the patience of his brother. So he referred to here to Prophet Yusuf alaihi salam. So he was so amazed by the patience of his brother, Prophet Yusuf alaihi salam, and his generosity. And may Allah forgive him alaihi salam. May Allah forgive. So Prophet Muhammad SAW wish Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive Prophet Yusuf alaihi salam. And he continued on that had it been him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would have asked for a release from the prison. Yeah, so he would ask to be released from prison had it been him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, before he interpreted the dream. Yeah, so that's why he was so amazed. Prophet Yusuf didn't ask, as we will see in the coming verses that we will review today, insha'Allah. So, okay, let's read these verses together, insha'Allah. So for today, insha'Allah, we will read verse number 47 until 49. Insha'Allah, yeah, 49, correct. A'udzu billahi minasyaitonir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Qala tazra'una sab'a sinina da'aban fama hasattum fadharuhu fi sumbulihi illa qalilan mimma ta'kulun. Thumma ya min ba'di dhalik summa ya'ti min ba'di dhalika sab'un shidadun ya'kulna ma qaddamtum lahunna illa qalilan mimma tuhsinun summa ya'ti min ba'di dhalika 'amun fihi yughasun nasu wa fihi ya'sirun. Sadaqallahu al-'azim. All right, for the purpose of our discussion today, insha'Allah, we will use these translations. So here, as we see in the we learn from the hadith earlier, that Prophet Yusuf alaihi salam didn't ask promise to be released from prison. Yeah, so he was asked to interpret dream, and even he immediately answered that. Yeah, he interpreted the dream for the fellow inmates. And remember, his former fellow inmates, because he was released. Yeah, this fellow inmate was released before. He had forgotten Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam for 7 years. And therefore, Prophet Yusuf stayed for another 7 years in prison. He didn't rebuke him. He was so patient, he replied to his request to interpret the dream. So Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam answered, or replied rather, you will plant grain for 7 consecutive years, living in the ear, whatever you will harvest, except for the little you will eat. So in other words, this is, remember last week, here the ayah, 7 fat cows eaten by 7 lean, and 7 grain spike of grains, and other that were dry. Yeah. So here, Professor Ali Salam was interpreting this one, the 7 fat cows. Yeah. So 7 fat cows in this dream refers refer to the 7 consecutive year of good harvest. But here. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam didn't just interpret the dream. He also give advice. Leave the ear whatever you will harvest. In other words, save from what you harvest, except the litter that you will eat, meaning the litter that you really have to eat, because people need to eat, right? So you eat, you harvest, and you eat what you harvest, but leave most of them, yeah? Except the litter that you really need to eat, okay? So this is it. So again, the third one, yeah? First, he didn't rebuke the person. Hey, where you been for 7 years? So he didn't rebuke that. Second, he didn't ask for a release of him from prison. He just reinterpret the dream. And even more than that, he gave advice to save the harvest. Why? They need to save what they harvest related to the dream in the next ayah. Then after that, it will come 7 years of great hardship. Yeah. So remember last week, seven fat cows eaten by seven lean one or seven skinny one here. Yeah. So this refers to the 7 good years of harvest followed by 7 years of drought. 7 years of drought. Yeah. Great hardship, or yeah, more or less the same. Yeah. So that's what the seven fat cow eaten by the seven skinny ones. Yeah. So there will come 7 years of great hardship. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam continue on, which will consume whatever you have saved. So earlier he said, save it, because it is going to be a 7 years of hardship, and everything that they save will be consumed during those 7 years of hardship, 7 years of drought. Yeah, except the litter that you will store for seed. So of course, even though there's drought, they will still store some to actually also plant during this year of drought. Not so many to be harvested, but life goes on, yeah. But luckily, they have, or it is expected that they would have saved, and those saving will save them from the years of hardship. And then in the next ayah, the next verse, Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam continued on. Then after that, there will come a year which people will receive abundant rain, and they will press oil and wine. So here, we didn't hear anything from the dream, right? The dream only said seven fat cows eaten by seven lean one and seven green spike of grain, and the other were dry. So where is this 1 year? Yeah. So of course, this is the full understanding of dream. So it's not just Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam didn't just interpret the dream. He also understood what happened, right? 7 years of good harvest and 7 years of drought. But of course, the end of the drought means there will be, it's considered the end of drought if there is an abundant rain. If there is no abundant rain, it's not the end. Yeah, it's just a normal life goes on, right? But here, the end of the drought means there's something special. And this is what it means by the one, the 15 year in this case, yeah, the abundant rain that in that year, they can press olive and grape. So, you know, in the drought, right? If let's say you have olive and you have grapes, right? Before you can press it for oil or for a wine, you would eat them. Yeah, you would eat the grapes. Don't bother to press it for wine. I mean, it's not important. Remember, these are people of Egypt, pre-ancient Egypt. Yeah, so they were not Muslim. So they drink, yeah. So rather than drink the pressed wine, of course they would eat the grape first. But they can press the grape to become wine because there are so many of them. There's so much the abundance of grapes. Sorry, yeah. So that's what it means, right? So brothers and sisters in Islam, here there are a couple of lessons that we can take. First of all, of course, is about patience. Yeah, as we said, even Prophet Muhammad SAW was amazed by the patience of Prophet Yusuf AS. He didn't rebuke, hey, where have you been for 7 years now? Yeah. Second, he interpreted him without making a deal first that he would be released from prison. He just interpreted him, right? And the third one, he even wished for a well-being. He gave advice. He gave advice, alayhi salam. Yeah. And remember, brothers and sisters in Islam, these people, they were not Muslim. They were ancient Egypt people. These are people who oppressed Prophet Yusuf. They put him to prison, right? For no matter how many years, plus another 7 years. And yet, Prophet Yusuf still wish for a well-being, still wants for a well-being of these people. Not only did he interpret the dream, but he also gave advice. Save what you had first, because drought is coming. Yeah, and even also put it put it in the ear itself. Yeah, as he said, alayhi salam, because it will stay longer. Yeah, can hold for 7 years. So this is one of the great lesson. Yeah, as a Muslim, Prophet Yusuf was although it's not considered at the time as Islam, as in religion of Islam now, but still the same teaching. The teaching of Tawhid, La ilaha illallah. Yeah. So Prophet Yusuf, like us now, we should wish for well-being, even for people that don't share the faith. Yeah. So now we live in Canada. Not everybody is Muslim, but still we wish and want for the well-being of these people. Yeah. Advise them for goodness. Barakallahu fikum, wa'afu minkum, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.